Today we're going to fix an STL using Meshmixer. We're also going to get it ready for color printing on a Bambu Labs printer using Tinkercad. So let's get cracking. This is Tinkercad.com. I choose sign in with Google. We're going to hit create brand new 3D design and let me show you the issue. A user, Lance, had a question via my Patreon messaging group. It is available for free to anybody that signs up. I'll put the bit.ly up above. Of course, I worked out a solution, and I'm going to share it with everybody right here. Lance shared that STL file with me. If we hit import and choose the design that was sent to me, I can click on it and hit open. Now, if you're looking closely, right here is your issue. Notice it says millimeters, and then the numbers are 0.25 millimeters. That's too small. If we switch this to inches, so that way it's converted to inches, and choose import, after a moment it does arrive, but there's some artifacts that I really don't want around this. So I'm going to take it to Meshmixer, and I'm going to fix it quick. If you've never used Meshmixer before, I do highly recommend it. I'll put a video up here in the corner that shows you how you can find it and install it yourself. Notice mine crashed. I do not want to restore the old project. I'm just going to bring it in and maximize it. Then we can choose import. Once again, we're going to bring in that same file. When it comes in, I do want to scale it up. So the first thing I'm going to do is Control A to select it all. And then under edit, I'm going to choose transform. And remember, this still thinks it's millimeters. So I'm going to convert it to inches by making it 25.4 times as big, because that's how many millimeters there are in an inch. So if I type 25.4 right there, bam, it snaps all the others. And now our design is the correct size to import into Tinkercad. I'm going to hit accept, and then I want to trim off this bottom piece. We're going to use something called plane cut. Simply going to click it. I'm going to use the arrow to pull it to the spot that I want to cut off. You can simply grab this blue handle and you can nudge it a little bit at a time. I like this because I'm going to have the flat edge. Once I click finish, I'm going to leave the fill type as remeshed fill. Bingo. All of a sudden, our design is pretty darn crisp. I'm going to stop right here because this does what I want. There are so many things you can do in Meshmixer. I do have a playlist. I'll put a link to it up here if you want to check out more options. Right now, though, File, Export. We're going to do STL in a binary format. And I'm going to make the name 1224R. And I'm just going to hit Save. Returning to Tinkercad, let's choose Import, choose File, and we're going to grab that new one. Keep the measurements this time and hit import. Note it still does take a moment. Let's nudge the old one out of the way so you can see how much better the new one looks. I'm pretty darn happy with that. Friends, let me show you now how to get this so it prints in three colors. All we're going to do is bring out the sketch tool. I'm going to line it up with this corner, but I'm going to do it in two steps because I didn't plan ahead. So I'm going to just drop this in this grid. Notice it is 20 by 20. Soon as I get in, I'm going to hit finish sketch and back out. And now I'm going to grab these two shapes, choose L for align, and I'm going to line it up with this shape's corner. Snap, snap. So that just makes it so that when we double click and go in, the part now fits to the grid. Now what we're going to do is just create a part that goes inside here that's going to be for the letters. Check this out. Because of the Bezier curves, we can just go in the middle of this area. Snap, snap, so I'm drawing straight lines, and just follow this around. We don't even have to get fancy with the Bezier curves. Right here, I will show you how we can. I'm going to do 2 to switch to Bezier curve mode, and when I click and hold, it bends. I'm going to just bend it up here. I'm going to do another one right here, just showing you how we can make this. Now, this one I do have to go under. So I'm going to click and hold, make that curve the way I want. Same thing down here. Click and hold and snap this back together. That is going to be the yellow fill. If we hit finish, notice right now it's super thick. We're going to just change that to 1 millimeter. And if we switch this to the black the user wanted most likely, bingo. This I think was supposed to be yellow. Bam. When you send this to the printer, I would send it as two separate pieces. It would print all of the black and it'll print all of the yellow just the way you want. Now we also want the R. So what we're gonna do is repeat that process. Of course, this time I've already got it lined up. So when I bring this one out, I can take it right to that 20 by 20 spot. So it's ready to build. Bang. Zoom back out. Let's move over here. Now this time I want to be a little more precise. I'm trying to fill in this R. I'm going to do that by shutting the grid off. I'm going to start with the straight lines of the R first. Notice I'm just following that outline that I think I can see. And then I can modify this after. I'll show you how to do that too. Just down to the corner. Up here, I'm going to make this curve. So I'm going to come short of the area, press number 2. I'm going to move to the other side, click and hold to make that shape I want. Press number 1 to go back to making a line. Snap, snap. I'm going to press 2 and make this a little bit of a corner too, just to make it a little more smooth. This, of course, needs to be a corner, so I'm going to go to the middle, click and hold, and bend it so it follows that shape. Once again, click, hold, bend to get what you want. Hit number 1 and finish it. Now, I said I could show you how to edit it. What we're going to do is double click. And then, like, this point seems like it needs to be a tad bit higher. You can just grab and move it. You can also take any of these points. See this dotted line? That's called a broken handle. That's this option. This would be a smooth handle. Notice it did that all the way around and adjusted them. I don't want that, so I'm gonna do Control Z. But you can click on a single point and switch it as well. So that would make it a round one. So now these are both symmetrical. They both move. Once again, I don't want that, so I'm going to do Control Z. I just wanted you to see it. Now, you may notice we've got this part right here that's a problem. We're going to fix that in a second. Let's first hit Finish Sketch. I'm going to change the height of this to 1. And I need to move it up to this layer. So I'm going to hit W for Work Plane, click right there, and hit D to drop. And let's quickly make that red because that's the color it's supposed to be. Now, we could do this without cutting out this middle piece, but I want to. So let me show you how I do this. Control D to make another one of those sketches. I'm going to change this one to a hole. And after clicking hole, I'm going to edit that sketch. Now, inside here, we're going to delete that, but we're going to delete it in a moment. First, we're just going to make a second sketch in here. And we're simply going to trace this part right here. Once again, I'm hitting 2, so it's curve, going halfway, making it bend. Click, hold, make it bend. Once I'm done, I can click on this one and I'm gonna delete it. So all I'll have left is this one. I can double click and click on those handles and adjust it. If these are ever in your way, like right now that's hard to grab, check it out. We can now hide them with the dimension menu. So I can get the exact shape I want. We can drag these points. This one right here, I think I want to be a little straighter along this edge. So I'm going to add a point. Bang, go back to the manipulate, and I can take this line, and if I hit number 1, straight line. I'm going to do the same thing up here. Once again, press 4, add a point. Click over here so that you don't accidentally delete what you just added. We got to go back to manipulate, which is the shortcut V. Once again, press 1, and now I've got the shape just the way I want it. Of course, you can tweak and adjust as much as you want. When you're done, hit finish sketch. Now that piece is a hole, so we can shift select our R, and when we do Control G to group, it cuts it out and we can see if we really like that. I like that I shared the technique with you, but I actually think I liked it better before. So right now I'm going to ungroup that, I'm going to delete that hole, and then also I'm going to adjust this corner right here because I don't have that exactly where I want. So I'm going to simply double click. And I bet you this happened when I did that modification. I can just drag this point where it's supposed to be. And bingo, that looks good. Once again, finish sketch. If you wanted these to completely blend in with the plastic, once again, you can simply grab those lines after you double click and edit and just move them a little further in. There's nothing wrong with having that multicolor sticking out. Finish, bingo. I think that merge is pretty darn sweet. Still gonna adjust this one right here one more time. Once again, double click. I'm gonna just grab this point and move it down so it's inside and hit finish sketch. W for work plane, I'm gonna put it back down to the bottom. As I wrap up, let's change the name, 1224. R, I like to send mine as STL files, so I'm gonna send it as three separate STL files. Let's start with the black outline, click STL, and I'm gonna just quickly add the word black after this one so I can tell which is which. And click save. Now we simply repeat that step for the yellow one, and of course do the same for the red. I do know you can do this with an OBJ file, but I do not like having to unzip them afterwards, so that's why I do it this way. So bringing it into Bambu Lab Studio, once again, we are going to add, and I'm going to grab all three at once. I like this because that way they come in aligned. I'm going to say yes, single object, multiple parts. Now I can simply switch to objects, and of course I want the black to be black. I want the yellow to stay yellow, and we're going to make the red, red. Bam. I do not really need this project, so I'm going to back up and I'm going to set it to the draft mode. And let's slice the plate. Notice everything turned out fine. It's going to be about 50 minutes. And let's print the plate, double check the colors, and send it to the 3D printer. Of course, after a moment, it bounces to the device menu. And once downloading completes, we can click on play and monitor everything from afar. And about an hour later, bingo, multicolor print turned out really, really slick. As you can see, those imperfections you could see when we were looking at it in Tinkercad, they just don't exist after printing. I'm also really impressed that this is all the waste that we had. As I wrap up, friends, I do want to say thanks again to Lance for the question. Super cool use of that Patreon messaging area. I also want to say thank you to everybody supporting me via YouTube memberships. Three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. One of my favorite benefits is you get early access to videos. Also, once again, huge shout out to the Patreon group. Love how it's growing. It's got a fantastic messaging area. You can learn more, of course, with the link up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.